Subway Surfers in my ass.
I love the Owl House. I love the Owl House so fucking much. I don't think I've ever said that explicitly in any of these videos, but I love this show. I also hate it because it seems like this show is on a one-man mission to make me lose arguments against myself, despite the fact that I said, and the Owl House is at its best when it's challenging expectations. I still came into season 3 with low expectations. And I'm gonna be honest with you, the Owl House has never warranted such a mindset. There have definitely been whiffs of maybe the show declining in quality a bit, but those declines never came. And I've always had questions about the show's execution, despite the season premiere being amazing. I still have questions on how the final two episodes will be handled, but I still felt like somehow the Owl House will fall off the deep end. And it didn't. There hasn't been that moment or that episode where I look back on and think, yeah, this is where it all went to shit. I mainly attribute this mindset to the Owl House's spiritual predecessors, who shall not be named, because I expected the highest of these shows only for them to fall flat on their faces. And I think the season 3 premiere has finally fully implanted in my head that the Owl House is one of the most unique pieces of television I've ever watched. Let's go through why. Alright, I gotta be a meanie bobini first. Why does it matter that Hunter is a grimwalker?
Thanks for not telling them that I'm
a grimwalker?
Shh, don't say it so loud!
From the Owl House wiki, I can imply that grimwalkers are just clones of other people. So what's the stigma? Why is he scared? This scene would make more sense if the other characters except for Luce didn't know that he was the Golden Guard. That way, that can make the realization that he was the one helping Bellows with the Day of Unity. But they already know Hunter is the Golden Guard, so he's just scared that they'll figure out that he's a clone. Who fucking cares? This scene feels oddly not natural. Despite the fact that what Luce is scared of makes way more sense than what Hunter's scared of, this bathroom scene could be taken out and nothing really changes. All it does is reiterate shit we already know. Does it sound like I'm nitpicking? I kind of have to. There's not really much wrong with this episode. Speaking of nitpicking, a question I forgot to ask in my last video was how long was it gonna take for the characters to get back to the demon realm? Like, in-universe. I knew the writers couldn't pull an amphibia and go on slice of life adventures. Maybe because they don't have 20 episodes to do so, Disney. So I figured because the season only had 3 episodes, the plot would be a bit more urgent. My prediction was the characters would get back to the Boiling Isles halfway through the first episode, and the amount of time that would have passed would be a week, maybe a couple, a month at max. How long has it actually been?
A siesta.
Siesta!
We've been here for months.
Months? Jesus Christ, everyone's fucking dead. Last time we saw that world, the Collector was turning everything into whatever the fucking Owl House is, and Ida lost an arm. I know the Collector probably won't kill everyone, but he could, and that's what scares me.
Do you miss it?
I miss knowing who I'm supposed to be.
I miss my dad.
Alright, this is as good of a time as any to mention this. I really wish Willow and Gus got more development so that I can actually care about them being away from the demon realm. I know a lot of people are gonna go with the headcanon of if the Owl House had a full third season, we would've gotten more of those episodes. And they're right, but I feel like we should've gotten more of those moments in the first two seasons. More moments of Willow with her dads and Gus with his dad. I just wish we saw a more personal connection that Willow and Gus have with the demon realm. Ah, yes, Hunter. Touch the fucking soup the gloop.
Oh yeah, soup the gloop.
With the cut finger. No wonder Bellows possessed you, you dumb fuck.
You're not Jacob. We can all thank Goddess for that.
You believe God is the one.
Goddess.
Have we met? Something about you seems familiar.
No, I'm new in town.
I'm gonna put this here because I have nowhere else to put this. Is it me or does the show look a lot cleaner? And no, I'm not talking about the scene, you know, the scene. I mean, the show has always looked amazing, but thanks to them, looks like it got a HDR upgrade. The designs, the faces, and the colors. That combined with the lighting makes thanks to them one of the most aesthetically beautiful Owl House episodes ever.
What a coincidence, me too. If you ever need a tour guide, hit me up.
We're actually here to ask about this old puzzle.
V, you're making a... What is this? It's all green and sticky and... Oh my god, ew, it's dissolving the floor.
Titan's blood! It's like you're reading each other's mind. You must have been friends forever.
Holy shit, that line sounded forced as hell. I'm pretty sure the writers could have found a better way for the characters to talk about the past few months.
I just want to make sure everyone's safe.
Same. And that includes you too.
What?
Yeah, gotta make sure you're safe too, Hunter. Your family now.
I know Lily Orchard is punching the fucking air right now.
I hope you're all prepared for a truly scary ride.
Make us cry! Make us cry!
Because there's nothing scarier than knowledge.
Boo! Just lie to me!
Man, college sucks. That has nothing to do with the scene, I just wanted to say that.
The tale of the brothers Wittebane. Wittebane? Isn't that Bellows?
No shit, Sherlock. Who the fuck did you think it was? Morgan Freeman? Although, admittedly, that would be a funny cameo.
Snitches and rats are not the same thing. Let me break it down to make sure y'all see what I mean. A snitch is someone minding other folks' business to find information they can sell for a price or trade for some other form of compensation.
You're such a hypocrite.
A rat is a traitor.
The secret code that Guy mentioned? It's a puzzle. A rebus we found in the shack. Amity thinks it leads to Titan blood.
Titan blood? Puzzles? Amity?
Ah, yes, because Amity was important in that discussion.
Hey, where's Luce and Hunter?
Can I see? I'm legally blind.
Oh. Wow, that laptop has the flimsiest hinges ever.
Mama says, I have to learn from my mistakes, so I know what I have to do now. On Halloween, after the hayride, I'm telling everyone I'm staying in the human realm. Permanently.
Luce, why are you putting so much blame on yourself? Why do you seemingly believe that your friends are so vapid that they think you, of all people, would intentionally do something malicious without outside manipulation? In layman's terms, why do you think that the situation that you're in is your fault? I would say that this is a character flaw, but this arc has been on loop for like the entirety of season 2. Especially in the season finale where Luce goes and fights Bellows on her own and almost sacrifices herself to keep the portal door open. Why are you doing this? What's the end goal here? It seems like Luce is written to have this hero complex where she wants to solve all the problems by herself, and she just can't. Kendrick Lamar said it best, Luce, you are not their savior.
Ah, there you are.
You know, Bellows, you sure are doing a lot of flaunting instead of making the portal and leaving, especially since it's as simple as slamming a vial onto a rock structure.
Because of you, we can finish our work as witch hunters, starting with them.
Why does this scene feel so abrupt? It looks great and has a lot of good ideas, but it doesn't flow properly. What the characters are doing is just so clunky for some reason. There's not really much of a fight. V trying to absorb Bellows' magic while looking amazing isn't a very practical choice. Like, V, you should know that that is probably way too much magic to absorb. But the final part is the most confusing, where they all rush Bellows from the same direction right behind one another. Cartoon or not, that's just fucking stupid. Now, I can think of two defenses that fans could play in response. They could defend the plot and say that even though Hunter was possessed, they didn't want to hurt him, which is why they were less coordinated than a YouTuber apology, which is fair.
I've made a severe and continuous lapse in my judgment.
Or they could defend the production, saying the scene was probably pretty expensive and the Owl House team probably couldn't get more ambitious or the price would have risen, which is also fair. But the Owl House has better fight scenes. Maybe not one that looks as good as thanks to them, but the fight scenes from Agony of a Witch and Eclipse Lake flow better and have a better sense of impact. And as for the first defense, the fight scene from O Titan Where Art Thou does a better job of portraying a defensive type of fight. My main issue is that a scene like this needs to be longer in order to get more structure. The scene in Thanks to Them is about 27 seconds. For comparison, the scene in O Titan is 36 seconds. A 9-second difference may not seem like much, but in a fight scene, a lot can happen in that time frame. For reference, this flurry between Ida and Lilith lasted 8 seconds, and this back and forth between Amity and Hunter is 7 seconds. So an extra few seconds or so could have helped the Triple T fight scene wonders. Now, I need to state, this scene isn't episode destroying bad or even initially off-putting. I was just as enamored as everyone else was on the first watch. However, is the smoother animation really worth a scene that's so off in execution? I don't think it is. Well, there goes Flapjack. The Arizona Cardinals lost their mascot like shit.
Flapjack! Flapjack, you'll be okay.
I love the look he gives her, like, bitch, you serious?
No!
Oh, no, no!
Move!
Well, there goes No, bitch, get back down there. Well, there goes Camilla. Taco, burrito, quesadilla, cinco de mayo, pico de... Oh my god, I can't believe I wrote that in the fucking script.
Avocados from Mexico.
That's the Belas you've been fighting this whole time?
Man, that's nothing. Wait till you see the literal child that turned the world into his playground.
V, call an ambulance.
Camilla? The fuck is a human doctor gonna do for a witch? Or a clone?
Do human doctors know about possession?
Or Grimwalkers?
Possession?
Grimwalkers?
He's a fucking clone! Seriously, why does this matter so much? Well, there goes Flapjack. Poor bastard didn't die the first time.
And I taught him the light spell. I introduced him to the collector. I set everything in motion.
I'm sorry, everyone.
Why did you keep all that a secret?
I was scared. I thought you'd all hate me for it.
I already explained why this sucks, so I'll just say this.
Now that I've seen what you're up against, there is no way I'm letting you go back alone. It is our duty to help your friends get back to their families.
Ah, yes, because you're gonna be useful. Unless you're gonna do something other than hit the villain upside the head with a chocolate, I'm pretty sure your game plan is moot.
What?
You were tricked. That's what Belas does. He tricks people. But if it weren't you, it would have been someone else, and then there'd be no one left to fight back.
Thank you!
Luce, I know things are scary, and I don't know what the future holds, but it would be so cool if you were a part of that. But no more hiding, okay?
I understand.
No, she doesn't. She's gonna do it next episode, I'm calling it. So that was my thoughts on the season 3 premiere. And I can't wait for the next episode in 2023? What the fuck? So you want to hear something really funny? In the previous video, I picked the release date of November because I thought that the three specials were going to be released in the last 3 weeks of October. However, as soon as I released that video, I found out that the last two specials were going to be released in 2023, which makes my brain itch. You'd think Disney would start to release the specials after they were all done, right? And if they are all done, why spread the release dates so far? I would rather wait several months for weekly releases than one release every few months. I guess this is the part where I say fuck Disney, right? Wrong. I'm not gonna do that this time. Not because I like Disney, they will forever be hoes in my book, but because I will admit when I've made misconceptions. In my previous videos, I know I pushed the belief that the reason why Disney canceled the Owl House was because of its LGBT representation. And while that would be funny in a sort of nihilistic way, and definitely would fit with Disney's business practices, in an interview with CT Insider, creator Dana Terrace says she faced a little adversity implementing the representation. But then I kept reading and I had a eureka moment.
Now promoting season 3, Terrace said the response to the show's premiere was next level, getting over 1.9 million views on YouTube within a few days. She said that it was the first time the television executives made the connection between online support and actual people watching the Owl House. At first, the executives would see the show trending every other day on Twitter and be like, oh, anyone can trend on Twitter, that doesn't actually mean anything, but seeing the views on YouTube and seeing the people who came to New York Comic Con gave them a much better idea that, oh no, the show is actually successful.
Are you shitting me? What is wrong with you?
I swear sometimes Disney is run by brain dead hyenas. From that statement, I can strongly imply that the Owl House was canceled in order to save money. The pandemic, combined with the show not getting high enough ratings, most likely gave Disney enough reason to cancel the show during the second season, along with that one guy who didn't believe it fit with the brand, whatever the fuck that means. It's just that if what Dana says is true, how the hell did they believe that the popularity of this show was a farce? What, they thought the view counts on the Owl House clips were a fucking glitch? But I can tell from what Dana says that she's tired of people talking about the show getting canceled and all the what ifs, and is just proud of her team for making something great. And you know what? I'm proud of her team for making something great, because I didn't expect thanks to them to be this well handled. This show is gonna make me eat my words, so I'm gonna say this. Do your best, Owl House. We're all rooting for you.